then how comes the rasa? I told, at last, it will attach to Trimarma, then prana apaya will be there. If prana apaya will be there, what is the methodology in Ayurveda to recover from the prana apaya? There is a terminology coming under the tantra called kala vanchana kriya. Kala vanchana kriya. We are tackling the kala. We are cheating the kala. Yama dharma. Actually, that is our area of protecting the patient, protecting the prana of the patient, emergency management, critical care. Actually, our term for critical care is not Atiyagi Chikilsa, but Kalavachana Kriya. So, if a patient, see, first of all getting Ajirna, then at last the Ajirna is changing accordingly to the involvement of Doshas like Vishtapta, Vidagdha, Rasashesha, Ajirna. At last it will change to Vishujika, Vishavat. So the body itself produces some Vishas in the body. So where you need Agata. So the critical care chapter of Ayurveda is Agata Tantra. So we need all chapters. We cannot separate Ayurveda like Kaya Chikilsa, Rasa Chikilsa and Agata department, Shandya department means. We should have a comprehensive approach. Agata department is where all the critical care should be taken. And you go through the Agata text like Vishanarayaniya or Prayoga Samuchaya or Uddisha Tantra or Sushruta Kalpa. You can see that much more drugs are metals and minerals and in even rasa. So the drug used in critical care is rasa, and the basic concepts are deriving like in Agata Tantra. That is the exact point where we are intervening with rasa. So the prana, what is the basic of selecting rasa is axis of this science. According to a birth of delivery of a baby, developing a womb in the body, Ayurveda narrates, Chudesh Plathave Sattvaha So Karma Klesha Chodidaha Garbha Sambadhyade Ukti Vasha Agni Nivarino Sushruta Sharira. Shuddhe Shukratave Sattvahasva Karma Klesha Chodidaha Sattvaha Sambadhyade. When this ovum and sperms are combining together, the prana is coming from outside with the sattva. So, when the prana means the Shiva plus Manas. Shiva is the nomenclature we are giving for the Vata. Actually, in Tamil, Vayu, there is another terminology called Vashi. The Vashi term only derived into Shiva form. If the Shiva, the pure form of Shiva, when combined with the Manas, the Raga, it will change into Prana form. When that same Prana is caged in the body, we call Vata. Mercury is the only material in the world which is having very much similar to prana. Mercury has different gatis. One of the gati is jiva gati. This jiva gati is very much similar to prana gati. So according to Samanya Vishesha Siddhanta, if you want to improve the properties of prana, you need such a drug which is very much similar to prana. That is nothing but mercury. Here the Adelis Mercury is addressed with the 12 types of poisonous things including the death. So how to make the samskara of Mercury to remove these things? That's your search of, and we found out that's why our 18 samskaras are derived. And we are using that Mercury in different forms. Next slide please. Mercury become very special. That is another hurdle. Usually when you are studying about the herb like Bala, Guruji, you will get a set of guna, karma, all these things. When you are studying about a aprata, you will get a specific set of guna karma. Gauri teja paramam amritam vata pitta kshaya gnam. Like that. Vata pitta kshaya gnam. Dosha karma is mentioned there. Dosha karma is mentioned for every metals and minerals, not for mercury. So we want to study mercury in detail. We want to use mercury in the body, because we found that it's very much similar to prana. So we found out another way. Mercury is classified into 25, depending upon its forms. And each forms are attributed to the set of guna karma. Kajjani is Sara, but Parpati is Grahi. After Ashta Samskara is called Parvatabadha. It's called Shanir Vyadhi Vinashana. This will cure only small, very slowly, all the diseases. When it's coming to the Parpati, support a Parpati, Kakhya, Bala Vyakhila Yoganut. It will cure all sort of diseases. There's one by one step, it's going ahead. In the Sringala Vedha, Acharya says, I'm not sure, even Shankara knows the properties of this mercury. So it is that much coming to a divine stage of action. So for studying mercury, we used another methodology. 24 forms, and we attributed dosha karma properties for the 25 forms separately. It's not like that. The dosha methodology is not attributed to the mercury. Yes. Next slide, please. See, I identified this much of physical chemical changes found in Ayurvedic drugs drafting. Oxidation, of course, encapsulation, crystal modification, magnetism, particle size reduction, organometallic combinations, photochemical reactions, mechanochemical reactions. This much changes are happening when you are preparing a bhasma. It's not simple. It's so complicated. So when you are making this simple, like vanga bhasma means tin nanoparticle. We are simplifying the science. So we are not going to the core of the science. Next slide, please. For the size reduction, we are using all these things. Preparation of decoction with herb and metals. Formation of nanoparticles. There is so many kashayams mentioned with gold, with iron. And further analyzation found that gold nanoparticle is there after preparing the kashaya. And you know the Sarasudharishtam very well. Detailed study is already published about Sarasudharishtam is contained nanoparticle of the gold. So all this methodology can produce nanoparticles of the gold. So we don't say that our basmas are only nanoparticles. That will be dangerous. Next slide, please. Then toxicity profile. After the completion of my PG from Jamnagar University, not only that, before that too I was using mercurials. My father was also using mercurials in different conditions, different diseases. But I got a suspicion only after my post graduation whether this is toxic or not. Before that I had no suspicions. I was using boldly, including Suji Gabran assignment in various conditions. But after getting a PG, I was so suspicious. So I went for an analyzation. Just I collected some patients. First of all, my name only, Shashi Kumar, 49. I got one visa point. I used so many Ayurvedic medicines. Then I went for just a rough study, blood, urea, and creatinine. So you can see blood, urea, and creatinine of these patients. I used severely Rasaushadas in these cases, like Chandamaritam, so many mercurials. After that, you get the figure, you know. It's very safe area. Next slide, please. Next slide. You know this paper is well, very famous about the Rasasandura. So Rasasandura is very safe. The safest form of mercury diseases in Jamnagar, where they found that when you are combining resveratrol a formula, it is augmenting its effect. Suppose you have a Chitra Harana yoga, take one batch of patients and give only herbs, one group with herbs and resveratrol. So the group with resveratrol, they found much result. So the resveratrol, of course, giving augmentation effect of the compound. Suppose you use resveratrol with Abhrabhasma, the effect of Abhrabhasma is augmenting. Suppose you are mixing the Abhrabhasma resveratrol with Pravalabhasma, the result of Pravalabhasma is increasing. So augmenting effect. It is so same by this published data. Next slide, please. This is the fundamental principles that we are following when we are administering the drug. Rasibhavati lohani mrutani suryavandi de haranti rogan sakala rasayuktani kim puna shilaya nashayateva vani panitarum jala. If you expand this concept, you will get mostly the drug crafting technology with this pharmacodynamics. Next slide, please. Yes, that this you should study very well. This is an important slogan, it's not a simple slogan. Yasya yogasya yo yoga teneva saha yojaye rasendro haradim vyadhi nara kunchara vajina. Suppose you are using a yoga for jwara, like bharinyadi kashaya. If you mix rasa in that one, it will augment the effect of bharinyadi kashaya and cure the fever will kick in. Any yoga you can take like that. That is the way how our rasa yoga sagara is derived. You can see the Arogya Vardhani. Take Arogya Vardhani. What is that? A combination of herbs with kachadi. Surya Prabha. Take Surya Prabha. What is that? A kachadi is there and so many herbs are there. To augment the compound, the herbal compound, we use the mercurial. Kachadi is used. Sometimes parpadi is used. Sometimes rasa sindura is used. Sometimes rasa basma is used. So rasa basma, see, it's very tedious to prepare rasa basma, all of you know. So in the middle position, rasa sindura you can prepare. And if you are going for multiple belijarana procedure, triguna belijarana, it's very safe. You can use this thing in infants, of course in small doses. And in pregnancy stage also you can use. Is very safe if you are going for at least for Triguna Belijarika. Next slide, please. So this is a table I'm usually using to teach my students. So the problem is when you are starting to practice the rasa preparations, you should have a rough idea about the potency of the raw materials. That they don't know. So this table will help you very well. Five tables. The first table comes the Sudhavargas. Anywhere you can use. Some of these things are safer than the herbal medicine. Like Pravala. Pravala Pishti, Pravala Basma. You can use in infants. 3 days old infant could be fed Pravala Basma with the breast milk. Nothing will happen. This is my daily practice at what I'm telling. And Shrangha Basma, you know. It's very safe. Shuktika, Kachabasti, Shankabasma, Varadika, Kukudandatok. So, then next is like Chara, Spatika, Surya Charam, Tankanam, Saindavam, Navasaram, Sasya Charam. And in the name of Rasaushadha, even these drugs are afraid of prescribing by the physicians of today's in Kerala. I don't know whatever the picture here. Shankabasma, they are afraid to prescribe because it's coming under the Rasa drug category. But unknowingly, they are preparing all the medicine. Mansangitra, whatever they are prescribing profusely. They don't know it contains Sarnamachika Basma and Loha Basma and all these things. Vettumaran, they are prescribing too much. It is nothing but the Ananda Bhairava Rasa mentioned in Ayurveda. It contains Valsanavi and Hingula, but it's profusely they are using. They don't know what's the context. So know the context, know the logic, and prescribe boldly. So this, and third, you see, third comes the rasayanas. We have maharasayana, we have uparasayana, we have sadharana rasayana. Of course, the term is used in another way. I just changed the term. The term used is uparasa, maharasa, uparasa, and sadharasa. But you should understand that it is not just maharasa, it is maharasayana. In the maharasayana category, you will get the safest rasayanas, which is very important. If you are preparing properly, you can use anywhere else. In uparasayana, it's little bit more potent. You should be little bit more cautious while using. And in sadharana rasayana, some arsenic contents are there. Only in emergency you can use. That's where you would understand. Then the fourth comes rasa and gandhaka. Both are in the same. Not only rasa. Gandhaka is also like that. One is Shiva, another one is Parvati. Shiva means, what is Shiva? Means you cannot derive mythologically. You cannot conclude the habit of Shiva. Same way you cannot conclude the properties of Mercury. It's a metal, at the same time it's liquid. It's a very big molecule, at the same time it's evaporating in room temperature. How it's possible? It's just like Shiva. It's behaving like Shiva. If you drink mercury, nothing will happen. Because element of mercury is not at all toxic, not at all allergic. But the mercury fumes are not like that. It will perish you. Like Kamadeva. See, sodium is toxic. Chlorine is toxic. But sodium chloride is not toxic. Every molecule in the body, you can see a combination of protein and metals. Hemoglobin, for example. So our drug is designed like that. We can give so n number of examples, but the expressions of in this form will not fulfill, will not help you to prescribe rasa drugs. For that, we need our slogan only. Ultimately, I will tell you. Therefore, then fifth. When you are prescribing the fifth one, be cautious. You should have thorough knowledge about that drug. Otherwise, it may cause problem. Then you remember the Charaka quotes. Yatha visham, yatha shastram, yatha agnira, shalir yatha, tatha aushadam, avinyatam, vinyatam amritam tatha, aushadam hyanavinyatam, nama rupa gunaistribihi. Nama rupa guna, you should know. Nama means very important. Sahachara. Even that, from the name itself, you will get a picture of that herb. Trigandaka. Like Abra. Abra is Gauri Teja. What is Gauri Teja? What is Gauri? What is Teja? Gauri means Girehe Apatyam Stri. The small mountains. Teja means the extract. So you think about the extract of a mountain. How many varieties of minerals, metals will be there in that one? That much mineral is there in the mica. Yes, of course. Mica is not a simple chemical entity. It's a highly complex manner. So if you are preparing a bhasma out of that one, means it will fulfill all the desires of the body at once. That's why Abra comes first. Gauri Teja Paramam Amritam. So the terms is not simply written here. In Sanskrit and Tamil, our ancient two languages are. When you are reading the term, when you are understanding the term, you should be more cautious. It's not like English. It's not like December. It's not like November. You know, according to terminology, December should be the Dekka, should be 10th month. But it is 12th month. November means it should be 9th month, but it's not now. 9th is the 11th month. That type of words you cannot see in Sanskrit. So the term is important. So, 5th, Haritala, Manashila, Gauri, Shankhapashana, Murdara Shrinka, Naga, Sasiga, Tamra, Nisakarpuram, and Sabviram. These are highly toxic things. Of course, we are using with cautious all these things if necessary. Everything we are using. But if necessary. Then you can see, from this table you can derive diseases. First of all, understand this about the Sudhavarga. Make a base of the... Now I am teaching how the direct drafting technology of Ayurveda works. If you know the direct drafting technology of Ayurveda, you can yourself draft according to the patient situations, the drug formulations. There is no need to go for specific combinations like Arogya Vardhini or these things. It is virtually impossible to keep all the drugs described in Rasayoga Sagara in a pharmacy. So how to make your own preparation? Suppose you want Ananda Bhairava Rasa, take some Himbula Bhasma, add Trikatu, and advise the patient to take in ginger juice and honey. It is nothing but Ananda Bhairava Rasa. Suppose you want Arogya Vardhini, Rasa Gandhaka Loha, Brush Shulpa, Bhasma Samanyutam, you know the combination. Take all this Bhasma and combine together, add some Kajali, and advise the patient to take in Nimbalu, Patra, Raswarasa, it will be Arogya Vardhini. That is the way how we make the combinations in the clinics and prescribe to the patients. Here, what I am telling you, first of all, you make base with the first category, the Sudhavarga. How to study? It's very easy to study how to select the Sudhavarga according to the diseases. In the Bheshachavacharaniya chapter of Ashtanga Sangraha narrates well about the clinical side of Ayurveda. And when it starts with the posology and the selection of the drugs, it says, consider the site of work of the drug, the srotas of the drug. So according to the srotas, the site of disease, you can select the drug. Same as in the pharmacology, modern pharmacology. So, understand the site of work of the Sudhavarga is very easy. Karmada, roughly I am telling, don't stick on to this one. You can and think your own. See, improvisation is possible in Ayurveda. Ayurveda is studying like a science and practicing like art. Modern science is empirical, that is on depending upon the statistics, it is math, it is very strict, and the improvisation is impossible. Here improvisation is possible. That's why your prescription, my prescription may be different. It is a plus point, I think. It's not a negative point. So, Kanmadam is working. Kanmadam is in Kerala. We are considering Kanmadam to Goputra Shilaidu and Karpura Shilaidu. Karpura Shilaidu as it chips up. So, this Shilaidu is working in urinary tract. So, if you have a urinary tract infection, you can first use any of this Shilajitu, Kanmada. Shringam. Shringam is working in heart, mainly. For hypertension, you can use Shringa Bhasma. It's giving good result. Then, Pravada Bhasma is working in chest, mainly. In one word, I am telling, not elaboration. And Shuktika. Shuktika is working in GIT. So in fever is starting from Amashayastva Hattva Agri. So in Navajvara, Shuktika is good. Then Kachavasti is working in rectal portion and intestine, big intestine. Then Shankha Basma is working in stomach. Varatika is a very good calcium rich one. It's working even in bones, in Sandhi, in OA, you can use this Varatika. And Kukudandatok is working in uterus and ovary and in brain. If you understand this way, you can alcohol you can use bravado. If you found which is inadequate, mix rasa sandura in that word or mix rasa. Any kajali or patpati or sindura. If you have basma, well and good. Then you can see that the effect of pravada is multiplying like anything. In just infection, with cough, with fever, you are getting a patient, take pravada basma, mix rasa sandura, add 10 drops of tulsi juice and honey and give thrice a day. It's anubana and sahabana. Anubana you can select, you studied well, any kashaya, tashamota gata thrive, any kashaya or any powder like sitopalati, alisapatravdaga, according to state of, according to climatic condition, according to the disease, you can select. But the rasa drugs, this you can select. This rasa drugs we are using to cut the peak of the samprapti. After that, you have to remove the rasa drugs and depending upon the herbal drugs, you have to cream. You have to treat. You have to proceed. That is the safest way. We have to play in a safe mode now. Then if productive cough is there, cough is not coming outside, then you have need some lekhana property drug. That time you jump into the second column, any of these chara, spadiga or surya chara or tankana, anything. Tankana is very good for productive cough. Tankana is good for throat infection. So mix rasa sandura, pravada basma and tankana basma and give in trigoda churna or tulasi juice or any media you know. Media you can select. Anubana and sahabana. Suppose it's in the urinary tract infection, what you can do? Take kanmada basma first of all. Your godadi basma, my kanmada basma. Take one dose and give Itupur Arnavadi Kashayam or Mansiachyadi Kashayam or any Kashayam, Brihatyadi Gana Kashayam. If it's not working properly, add Rasa Sanduram. So Kanmada Basma plus Rasa Sanduram. And if there is block or something like that, jump into second. Like what you can do, you can add Surya Kshara. It's a highly diverting. Then, that's why. When you require the third one, when the disease is so chronic, when you need to boost the immunity of that patient, you can select the third column. Metals and rasayanas. Everything is there. Fourth already we described first of all. Fifth, if you are getting acute, suppose you are getting pneumonia, then mix rasa sanduram, pravada basma, tankana basma, haritala basma. A combination. That's way, see now 1 hour is not enough to describe all these things day by day, disease by disease, but this is an example you can very much utilize. That is the way. In the next session, see if somebody is there, they can describe more.